I was told I was very uncool by my teens.
Yeah.
So
that's true because yeah. Well, no, not that you were uncool.
I was very uncool.
I was that, so let's be honest.
Yeah. Yeah.
I swear that there are writing vibes in different places.
Yes.
I know that's ridiculous. But I would, like, my first book I wrote in a particular coffee shop. Mm-hmm. My second book I wrote at the bookstore.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third and fourth book, this place has been working out for me, like, the, where I'm at now, yeah, Starbucks. And I like that place. But I think sometimes switching your location can kind of help unblock stuff. Sometimes I'm staring outside the window at Starbucks, it's really bright, you know, and I'm thinking for a while. I look at my computer and I see all these little black dots, you know, so, but that's how writing goes sometimes.
And I think it's really easy to kind of keep going on forever. If you don't have like some sort of a deadline or a goal in mind, you can just keep working on a book and never finish. You can keep writing and keep adding. Like in a month, I want to finish one chapter. It could be something as small as that. Forever. If you don't have like some sort of a deadline or a goal in mind, you can just keep working on a book and never finish. You can keep writing and keep adding and keep editing and keep doing this, and it'll never be a final product that you ultimately want it to be. So having these kind of list of goals, whatever they are, even if it's small, and saying like in a month I want to finish one chapter, it could be something as small as that. But as long as you have something to work towards, you know that you will be continuing this process of going on. I think that is actually a good point, is to have writing friends.
Yeah.
Whenever we meet and chat, I'm 1,000% more motivated to work because I talked to her, I got something done, and I'm like,